project for the past 2 weeks has been planned in such a way that the older children have been helping the younger ones, and the younger ones have been encouraged that you should be able to ask for help without any hesitation. So they've all pulled it together. So it's a very small reflective session that we have. Why I'm talking to you is that I also want the parents to understand what to expect out of them. Please don't hold back. They're young ones, I know, but please question them. Ask them what they learned, why do you think like this. And you know, I'll tell you one simple example. When we went for the Star Bazaar survey, they were just trying to identify what's two-stage process. I'm not, you know, disclose it, let them talk about it. They were to identify if the plastic is still being around, because we talked about a plastic bag. So one of the older children, they child went and picked up one of those packets that is used for picking up those loose grains. It's written biodegradable. So the older child said, oh, this is biodegradable, so that's okay. The best part was, great one child said, what is biodegradable? And my older child spent good 10 minutes trying to explain that to her, saying that if you dig this up into the sand or mud and you leave it there for 15 days, probably 20 days, then what happens, you know? But best part was that my older child had the patience, stand there, explain it to them, convince her before moving it. And I really appreciate that learning being taken very positively by the child, in spite of the fact that it was new for them, they're not ready to move away at all. And that's exactly what we wanted these students to. Two of the customers there in fact appreciated our students saying, because we had, you know, the teachers had talked to them about how to talk to a stranger safely, but yet be polite. So they started with, thank you so much, may I help you? And two of the customers in fact asked, which school are they from, they're talking, and they literally ate the store manager up. No, we had just requested for 5 minutes because they were starting a business, but I'll show you the pictures also. They literally surrounded him and went beyond the questions that they had thought about and kept asking him, you know, how do you think the business is going to be impacted if the plastic is, you know, taken away? And those questions that came impromptu because they were building upon it. It's not the reverse question. So we were very, very happy about how the children went about. Now today we wanted you to be a part of their sharing process.
Teaching us to do songs. films and activities, films of shapes. That's how we're learning. They're in this house and just helping us to know the, you know, like the plastic, the use of a plastic, whether there is a bad or a plastic. All these things that he uses. So really, like, I'm thankful, like, whatever he's learning, he should actually.
Our main focus was to get them conversant first. So grammar, exercises, vocabulary eventually is going to come. But first they need to be comfortable in the language. They need to be comfortable enough to make mistakes, speak, pronounce well. So that was the focus. And
yes, children understand mathematics and basic ESL standards. So in grade 1, 2 and 3, we started with a small activity of what we really need in our real life. And then demonstrate that they had that design their own bedroom.
I would tell it learning because I had learned more rather than teaching them. And let me tell you one thing, these children, they have their own style, their ways of learning. They have the fire of learning, which we saw during our Star Bazaar visit. And when they were asking questions, you know, they had their own lead, their own way of learning. So he said, will leads to way, that I could see in them, that they had a will and to learn in a different way. And that's when they had asked ample number of questions, the staff, the customers, and then when they were buying the products, they were in a dilemma, we have 50 rupees, what we should buy? Should I take this? Oh, this is 80 rupees, I don't have less money. I should buy for my mom, I should buy for my father, because there was a lot of things that went into it.
We must have a collaborative class, the mixed age group, and as facilitators, we couldn't have any answer, we had an exciting classroom, the environment was very friendly, there was so much support, so much empathy.
That was effective, very good, that was and had a case of like a tree. So, one can see how a tree is effective with just dumping plastics around the ground. So, that's what I want to share with you. And I think art is the purest form of expression. I think expression is louder than words.
Students watch, let us tell you what we have seen. Oh my, such dreadful sights, such ghastly scenes.
And we took a story down through our streets, and all we could see was plastic beneath. Plastic waste here and there, toxic waste just everywhere.
Everyone of you,
it's not just up to us, but you.
Let us gather and take an oath.
No more plastic. We are the reason why. It seems so difficult to even try. So how we could want to away from the metal of the army. We are the metal of the army. We are the metal of the army.
Hello, I'm glad that GIS started with this Cambridge way. We were looking for a different curriculum for my daughter because she was not very happy with the regular course. And I'm really glad that the school started with this Cambridge way. I can see a drastic difference in the way my daughter has accepted this school. She's very happy, keen to go to school and very excited. She calls me excitedly every day after school and tells me how her day has been. And I don't have to worry about her homework anymore. She doesn't need my help, she just completes it. And originally we were afraid how is she going to adapt to the new curriculum because she normally doesn't like to write. So thanks a lot, GIS.
Very happy that GIS has started with this Cambridge wing. As I've seen in the 2 weeks, the bridge course period time itself, a big difference in my daughter. She's very happy. I have seen her grow emotionally as well as mentally. So there has been information like which has been helping them out totally. And the foreign languages also. So it's a good experience for them. And the teachers are amazing. They're providing a very healthy environment where the child is growing. And they're growing just not with information or with knowledge, but also mentally, socially, emotionally. Thank you, Jia.